Good morning, fourth hour. As you can see on the screen, starting slightly differently today, I'm going to first talk about junior meetings. So if you're a senior, you can feel free to either finish that athletics survey on Schoology, or you can go ahead and open up your Schoology work. But for you juniors, I want to make sure I go over this. So what these meetings are is every year the counseling department does this. They pull aside the juniors in little groups so they can basically talk to you one-on-one about what your plan is for life after high school. And then they can help guide you to scholarship options, letting you know what the counseling department can do to help you out with your life beyond high school. So that's what this is. Where and when is it? So for you hybrid learners, it's going to be Tuesday, because you folks are Monday and Tuesday. Thursday and Friday kids are going to be meeting on Friday. All of you are going to go to the media center at your assigned time. You don't have to report to class for attendance, right to the media center. If you don't know when your meeting is, I've included this document that you're seeing here is in Schoology in two places. It's in your week four folder and on the Schoology main page for the course. So you just click on this hyperlink to find out when your time is. When you go to the media center, you're going to need to bring a device because you're going to be completing an online form. I would recommend a charged iPad. For distance learners who may be watching this, you have two options. You can either meet today, Monday, so it looks like this time's almost done, or your option is going to be Thursday then. Thursday at 2, click here to join the Google Meet for your meeting. I would strongly suggest a couple of things. One, when you find out your meeting time, put an alarm or reminder in your phone so you remember. Second suggestion, guidance is going to have you fill out a test choices survey. They've already sent it out to you, but my guess is it's probably like a lot of surveys where we're struggling to complete that kind of stuff. So take your test choices survey before you go. And I've included a hyperlink to that. So in other words, guidance is going to ask, do you want to take the ACT or another test? What test do you want to take? And they'll give you your three options. And then third suggestion, make sure your iPad is charged so you're ready to go for these meetings. And of course, if you have any questions about these, we can absolutely talk about them in the G-Meet. I'll be here the whole time. All right, so I want to show you where you're going to write this week's work and then go over what the work is. So this week, you have two main tasks. They're split into two things. You got formative and summative. So formative, as you recall, is 40% of your grade, and summative is 60. So I'll just show you right on the screen here. So the summative points this week are going to be on making goals and writing a reflection on your introduction speech. And of course, I'll go over how to do that. So you're going to write a reflection paragraph and make some goals. That's summative. Formative are two things. You're going to be reading today letters to a future speech student, writing what you think about the advice they give. So that's the first part of formative. So 4 points, as you can see on here. And then the second part of formative this week is tomorrow. I'm going to be teaching you about performing concepts we use all semester, and these are called PV legs. So you're going to show your learning and thinking for that formative, PV legs, all right? As per usual, I have all the tasks on here separated out for you and where you need to write things. So for example, for summative, your goal making, you're just going to write on this screen here what your semester goal or goal is, your goal for your next speech. And then here, you'll write your paragraph. And of course, I'll show you how to do that. Here is where your letter to a future speech student answers go. And then finally, here's where you're going to write reactions and your thinking and learning to the PV legs. Notice I've given you all the terms and their definition, so it's not that kind of note-taking. It's you writing the things you think are most key to remember it. All right, so that being said, now that you know where it's going to go, let's show you how. So like I said, today I'm going to teach you how to write your goals, how to write your reflection paragraph, and how to get started on that letter to a future speech student response. Tomorrow, I'm going to teach performance concepts. So if you're at your junior meeting, the slides are already in Schoology for you, and you, of course, can watch the video of those notes. Same kind of deal here with your week four checklist, just breaks those things down in the way I just went over. I do have open office hours every day this week, so just click on here and join me, and that's typically during fifth hour, except Wednesdays it's 2 to 3. All right. Oh, pardon me, that's typically during sixth hour, not fifth. Tomorrow, I'll tell you the first CTA, and I just put the title here. So I'm going to tell you about the first time I ever gave a speech. If that's not your jam tomorrow, I'm going to start with class with the story, so you're more than welcome to work on your work ahead of time rather than participating in the CTA. That's fine. All right, so here are your notes.
We can't see the PowerPoint.
You can't see it?
Yeah, it's still on the, there we go.
Thank you. Goodness. Mondays. All right. So now let's show you notes now that you can see them. Yikes. Here are several gestures that you can try if you aren't sure what gesture to make. I've included an image here of several for your next speech. So first, let's talk about goal making. So you want to think on what you want to do by the end of the semester and what you want to accomplish by the next speech, which is going to be informative. I've added some sentence starters for you here to write that. You're welcome to use any of these. So for example, in performing my next speech, I want to feel more, or I want to have a more clear voice the next time because. So that's for the next speech. And then what do you want to be able to know, do, or feel by the end of the course? Some students in the past have written, my goal is to pass. There's nothing wrong to write that as a goal. That absolutely works if that's your goal. Then you're going to write an introduction reflection on your speech. So those of you who haven't done the speech yet, you need to get that in. I have about four of them. The four I have, fantastic. Very, very good. But I need them from the rest of you. You're also going to need to get that speech in before you write this. So as you can see, it's an academic paragraph. So we got a topic sentence that says exactly what I'm going to talk about. And yes, you can use this as a model for yours. Then at least three sentences in the body supporting the topic sentence. So at first I wasn't sure what to write, so I looked at the example. Once I had my draft done, I practiced a little home to make sure it was long enough, get the idea. And then finally, you write a conclusion that either says what you learned or what you'll do next time. So overall, my introduction speech was a bit quiet. So next time I'll work on being more loud and clear, or whatever it is. So that's how you do the summative work this week. I want to show you next about your letter to a future speech student. So this is where, so what this is, and I started doing this years ago, the last two semesters of speech one, wrote these letters for you as part of their goal reflection writing and as part of their exam. So usually as part of the final, I have a letter like this. This is why I want to show it to you. And yes, in a minute, I'll show you some examples of the letters. So the letters have the intended audience of you folks, students new to speech one, and they're meant to give you advice on how to succeed in public speaking, in the course. Some of them have included how to succeed in life. It was up to each student who wrote these if they wanted to include their name. Some of them include like a funny name, like your boy, stuff like that. I have not edited their responses. So I left typos, I left misspells, because I'm not really concerned about that, frankly. The content is more important. What am I going to do with these things? So you're going to read at least three of the letters. And I'm going to give you time in a moment here to do that. You're going to feel free to share them with other people. So if there's something funny in it, read out loud. You're going to decide what advice is good and maybe not so good. And you're going to write that down. So piece of advice one, I thought this was good advice because the first advice they gave me was to be prepared. I thought that was good advice because blah, blah, blah. If you can't find two bad things, so if you're like, they're all really good, then just do four really good examples then. That's fine. You're going to find these in your week four folder on Schoology. Try to get out here so I can show you this. And then last question I have on here is, will I write a letter like this? It really depends on whether or not we have a final this year. So last year I offered it as an alternative. Typically your final in here is reflective. So you won't have to take like a big test at the end on terms or anything. Instead, it's here's how I did throughout the year and here's what I think I learned and that kind of thing. And that's if we have a final. It's really doubtful, to be honest with you, right now, whether or not we will. So I will, of course, keep you posted on that. So let me show you what the letter to the speech student looks like. If I can get my tabs to work here. This computer's being a little temperamental today. Hopefully on the screen, you can see it says letter to a future speech student. According to my screen, you can. All right, so I already told you the background part. So here's where the letters start, below this dotted line. Like I said, some have signs on them, some do not, meaning some are signed, some are not. But you're gonna read three of these, and these are in your week four folder, and decide what's good advice and not so good advice. Right. Tomorrow, I'm gonna show you how to do PV legs. So what these terms mean, I'm giving you examples of how to get ready for them. So we'll use these terms, PV legs, all semester. So you'll be learning more about those tomorrow. And then in optional resources, I've included some background on how to make a goal and a little bit more on how to get your brain to focus if you struggle with that. So at this point, I'm gonna stop talking so you folks can have time to do these things. Like I said, if you have not done your intro speech, please do so. You're more than welcome to film in the hallway. I'll be in the meet. If anyone has any questions, go for it.